God forgives. I don't. In other words, retaliation is a must.
What's up, everybody? It's your boy, Mr. T-Money 1993, back with another video. And this is going to be no D1 left behind, you know. We're going to educate him on why he should not get in the NFC South business, especially looking at his team, you know what I'm saying? But here's a clip of D1 and his interaction with the other three teams in NFC South.
When you're grateful to your man, it's going to feel as if you are giving him head and fucking him at the same time. Erect, what you're gonna do is replace the grapefruit from your mouth. You're gonna twist up and down on his shaft and suck the head at the same time.
This bitch nigga talking about one time. Let's talk about the one time y'all had a fucking winning season, bro, in the past 10 years. Let's talk about that shit, man. One time. Nigga, when was the last time your one time was? This is like the nigga who get mad. You know, when you and your nigga, both of y'all single, and then you get a girl, your nigga be mad at you all the time and having a little attitude because now you ain't got enough time for him and all that kind of bullshit. Come on now, son. You walk into the fucking year every fucking year and know that you gonna lose that shit. Patriots won 11 out the last fucking 13 division titles, bro. And you really gonna, you worried about my division. Worried about your fuck ass AFC East bullshit division, bro. Worried about how y'all had fucking 2 division wins. We not even in y'all motherfucking division and we had 3 division wins. Come on, son. You worried about my team? You worried about my weapons? Worried about how Mike Wallace can't fucking catch? Where about how no Sean Marino came in overweight as fuck? And they said looking bad. And you might have to start Lamar suck-ass Miller again. Where about your motherfucking team for you step to mine, bro? You ain't ready for this shit, bro. No matter how you shape it up. You worry about your bullshit-ass division, bro. Y'all division is trash. Garbage. It's Patriots and who the fuck else? That's it. Like, come on now. I expect better out of you, D1. But I'm going to teach you today, bro. You're going to learn not to fuck around with the NFC South no more. And especially not the fucking Carolina Panthers. And you saying something about my... Like I said, you saying something about my weapons, man. You don't remember what my weapons outside of Steve Smith and all them boys that left did to you? I got a little reminder for your bitch ass.
127 yards and a touchdown. Third quarter, still 16-6. Here come the Panthers. Second and 7 from the Dolphins 36. It's Cam doing Cam Newton things. Avoids the pressure, scrambles for 8 yards, and a new set of downs. 4 plays later, first and goal from the 5. Cam Newton, of course he's going to take it himself. That's Cam Newton. Panthers cut the deficit to 16-13, going 83 yards in just under 7 minutes. In one from the Panthers 48, Newton goes right, gains 8 yards for a first down. Rashad Jones called for a late hit. That's going to add 15 yards to the play. Look at Newton smiling. Yeah, he's got 15 more yards. First and 10 from the Dolphins, 29. Mike Tolbert takes the pitch. Look at Mike Tolbert all the way down to the 6. 2 plays later, second and goal from the 1. Cam Newton, no play action. Greg Olsen, a bullet to him, a touchdown. Panthers take a 20-16 lead.
And nigga, you tried to say something about me saying something about fucking Steve Smith. Wasn't you the one that fucking on low-key dissed Dan Marino? So don't come at me with that bullshit. And as far as Ron Rivera, that was, you know, media talking shit. Check my earlier videos last year. Even when we started off 0-2, I said don't panic. Ron Rivera know what he's doing. He's a defensive coach, and our defense improved every year since he's been there. You can't knock that no matter how you shape it up. But really... had to teach your ass today, bruh. Instead of no child left behind, this shit, no D1 left behind. Real talk. And you talking about, oh, Cam, if you believe Cam can't do anything with no weapons and this, that, and the other. Man, come on. I'm not, Panther Nation not the only one that feel like this. Check this off Bleacher Report, man. Mike Freeman said His belief, he hears from scouts and personnel men more than anything this offseason, is a belief that Newton will elevate his already impressive game to the point where we put him in the same sentence as Luck or Rodgers. Newton is already close. He's like Brady in that the offensive talent around him hasn't been that good. Look for Newton to make a huge leap, and he predicted Cam Newton to be offensive player of the year. So it's not just Panther fans that see a lot out of Cam this year. And you talked about all our weapons is old and we'll be rebuilding in a couple years. Only people that we signed that is older is Jason Avant and Jericho Cotri. You're not counting Kelvin Benjamin, who we just drafted. You're not counting Taquan Underwood, who's still, what, 20-something. You're not counting Tavares King, who has a chance to be good and get playing time this year. When he was at Georgia, they had him as, what, the next A.J. Green. And you talked about Marvin McNutt, and I know his name's funny. Ha, 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 niggas laugh, bullshit. But if he steps up and plays this year, hey, his name can be whatever the fuck he wants to be. Also, we got that boy, that fast boy from Ohio State, Philly Brown, who already been burning people at OTAs. So, we not that old. We got two older niggas who's mentoring like they supposed to, like we want them to be. Like, Steve Smith's older than both of them, so I don't know why the fuck that matters. But, come on now. Worry about your fuck-ass team. Worry about if Ryan Tannehill is a fucking franchise quarterback, because we still don't know that shit yet. I know who my franchise quarterback is, and that's Cam Newton, Super Cam, whatever you want to call him. It don't matter what the fuck you saying, man. Worry about your fuck-ass division. Stay out the fucking NFC South, because the Kings of the South is here, man. No matter how you shape it up, we at the top right now. We're going to do it again. Do I automatically think, you said something about winning the Super Bowl, I think either you said it in your video or in the comments. No Panther fans ever said that. My prediction is the same as it was last year. 10 to 12 wins will go into the playoffs and have a chance to shoot for a Super Bowl. Yes. Other than that, we're going to shape it up as it is. Top 5 defense. Running game still good. Tight ends. We added tight ends. We're going to be running more two tight ends this year. Receivers. We're deeper at receiver. Cam Newton's Cam Newton. Like I said, this your boy, Mr. T-Money, 1993. I'm out. As my other sons, you know, y'all want daddy's attention. Y'all gotta take it by time. Do you want Kane first? You know? Can't remember who came next. I know I still got my son Joe Rock still needs some attention. I see my son Air Falcon drop another video. My other son Sports Lives dropped another video, aka Bill Lambier. I think my other son Sean J. You know, I know y'all need daddy's love.